Welcome to the session on what is Pegasus spyware and how it works. The Pegasus project, an investigation by an international media consortium, has revealed that more than 50,000 phone numbers were targeted by a spyware created by NSO Group. An Israeli software company on the list were 300 verified phone numbers in India, including those of ministers, opposition leaders, a sitting judge, more than 40 journalists, and several activists and business persons. But what is Pegasus? Who is it for? How does it infect devices? And what can it do? So these are certain questions we shall answer in this session. A spyware is any malicious software designed to enter your computer, device, gather your data and forward it to a third party without your consent and knowledge. Pegasus was developed by NSO Group. It's perhaps the most powerful spyware ever created. It is designed to infiltrate smartphones, Android and iOS, and turn them into surveillance devices. The Israeli company, however, markets it as a tool to track criminals and terrorists for targeted spying and most mass surveillance. NSO Group sells the software to governments only. A single license which can be used to infect several smartphones, which can cost up to rupees 70 lakhs. According to a 2016 price list, NSO Group charged its customers $6,50,000 to infiltrate 10 devices plus an installation fee of 5 million rupees. How does it work? Let's answer this question. Pegasus exploits undiscovered vulnerabilities or bugs in Android and iOS. This means a phone could be infected even if it has the latest security patch installed. A previous version of the spyware from 2016 infected smartphones using a technique called spear phishing. The text messages or emails containing a malicious link were sent to the target. It depended on the target clicking the link, a requirement that was done away within subsequent versions. By 2019, Pegasus could infiltrate a device with a missed call on WhatsApp and even could delete the record of this missed call, making it impossible for the users to know they had been targeted. In May that year, WhatsApp said Pegasus had exploited a bug in its code to infect more than 1,400 Android phones and iPhones this way, including those of government officials, journalists, and human rights activists. It soon fixed the bug. Pegasus also exploits bugs in iMessage, giving it backdoor access to millions of iPhones. The spyware can also be installed over a wireless transceiver located near a target. The next question to be answered, what can it do? Once installed on an iPhone, Pegasus can intercept and steal more or less any information on it, including SMS, contacts, call history, calendars, emails, and browsing histories. It can use your phone's microphone to record calls and other conversations, secretly film you with its camera, or track you with GPS. Let's get to know certain background aspects relating to who has been targeted. Arab royal family members, 64 business executives, 85 human rights activists, 600 plus politicians, government officials, journalists, and several iPhone users. Let's know a few brief history of Pegasus. 2016, researchers at Canadian cybersecurity organization, the Citizen Lab, first encountered Pegasus on a smartphone of human rights activist Ahmed Mansour. September 2018, the Citizen Lab published a report that identified 45 countries in which Pegasus was being used. As with the latest revelations, the list included India too. October 2019, WhatsApp revealed that journalists and human rights activists in India had been targets of surveillance by operators using Pegasus. July 2021, the Pegasus Project, an international investigative journalism effort, revealed that various governments used the software to spy on government officials, opposition politicians, journalist activities, and many others. It is said the Indian government used it to spy on around 300 people between 2017 and 19. This question is yet to be answered by the government. So this session would have helped you to know about Pegasus, the spyware app. Thank you all for watching this session.